Hi there, and welcome to the show that doesn't have a name yet. Yeah, I think I'm gonna do something with that someday. But let's first begin with my very first topic of the show. My Little Pony, Friendship is Magic. You know, my first reaction was actually about the same as some skeptical people react to this video. The show is actually marketed for little girls. But does that make the show as bad as it sounds? Well, no, you should actually give it a chance. And I will tell you why. The first cracks in my resistance was when people talking about the show mentioned the name Lauren Faust. Yes, my reaction was the same. I'm not someone who knows the names of people involved in various shows and series, but even I knew the name Lauren Faust, and not like I knew the name Michael Bay. Dun, dun, dun. Still, I remembered the original show from when I was young, and let me be honest here, I was afraid that people would start to doubt my manhood when I started to watch the show. I know it's shallow, but aren't we all a little bit shallow sometimes? But let's just be honest here, with one example, just one. These are the early 2000s Pinkie Pie and Rainbow Dash. That's not Pinkie Pie and Rainbow Dash. Those are demons spawned from hell. From hell, I tell you! And even though hell equals evil, evil equals dark side equals cookies or cupcakes. Sorry, I couldn't help myself. This are the Rainbow Dash and Pinkie Pie I prefer. And that's the early 2000s series, not even the series I remember, where I will spare you from because it is that horrible. That was the real thing that was stopping me. But seriously, Lauren Faust and so many serious people liking the show so much, I had to give it a chance. So I said to myself, Ardawen, you have to at least watch the first 5 episodes before you can truly judge it. And it was okay. I did not dislike it. At least that was what I told myself. In secret, I was already sold after the first 2 episodes.
A manticore!
A fucking manticore! Now I'm proud to say I love me some pony handquarters.
Dude, that's creepy.
Yeah, sorry. Can't you even take a joke, Spike? I just really like the show. There, happy? Anyway, it took me a while to really understand why I like my Little Pony so much. But you know, when I looked at the big picture, it actually makes sense. Okay, so there is a lot of cute, sweet and icky stuff in My Little Pony Friendship is Magic. And I know I joked a little bit about it, but you know, some of the adult male fans are really creepy, and I know that.
Hey, quit poking me with your thing.
Now, before you begin to attack me, I know most male fans are pretty much just like I am. They just love the show a lot and they are not afraid to admit it. However, there is some really creepy stuff out there that's stopping a lot of people from actually giving the show a chance, like cupcakes, for example. One of the other reasons that stopped me from watching My Little Pony Friendship is Magic was that the show looked so horribly bright and colorful. But underneath the icky stuff, there is so much more. The artwork is actually really, really good, and not always as bright and colorful as you might think. Yeah, this is from the actual show. Granted, even in this episode there is cutesy and happiness, but it's My Little Pony, what do you want? But looking through all the goo, sparkles and rainbows, there is actually a really worked out storyline. With some solid humor and some really good winks at pop culture.
Hello, Rarity!
Was your zebra sense a tingling?
Talking about well worked out, the writing cast and the voice actors really make the world come alive, and no matter what show you're watching, you should really appreciate that. Okay, they are kind of predictable. I mean, you have the daring one, the shy one, the beauty queen, the workaholic, the nerd, etc. But within these shells of characters, there is so much more worked out, and they really do a really well job with it. The last reason I like the show so much is the songs. Granted, most of the songs are still sugar-coated, like this one. But some are more darker and sinister, like this one.
This day has been just perfect. The kind of day of which I've dreamed since I was small. Every pony I'll soon control. Every stallion, mare and foal. Who says a girl can really have it all?
I bet that was a little bit darker than you expected from a show called My Little Pony Friendship is Magic, wasn't it? There. Those are my reasons why I like My Little Pony Friendship is Magic. I hope you had a little bit of insight in my reasons, even though you might not agree with them. And if you haven't yet, at least give the show a chance. Watch the first 5 or 6 episodes. You never know, you might like it. Now, I cannot end this episode about My Little Pony Friendship is Magic without ranking the main characters of the show. I will also include Spike and the Cutemark Crusaders in my ranking to make it a top 10. Are you ready? Here is my ranking of the main characters of My Little Pony Friendship is Magic. Number 10, Rarity. Okay, I do not hate Rarity. Oh, wait a minute. Yes, I do! I mean, come on! Even her cat hates her! And who can blame the animal? Look at how she's treating it! She's a horrible, horrible pony! Horrible! She is a snobbish, pretentious bitch who has a fucking hard time choosing between her friends and her career! But the choices are fucking obvious! She would literally be like, geez, I don't know, I could save my friend from the burning building, but I have a really important witch client waiting for me, and I don't want to ruin this dress. And even worse, do you know how manipulative she is? Remember that episode with the diamond dogs? I actually felt sorry for the diamond dorks. I really, really did. And they were supposed to be the bad guys! God! Oh, and she is family with over 30 illegal immigrants, but that's a story for another time. Number 9, Twilight. That's not Twilight. Twilight Sparkle? The vampire said what? Fuck yes! try that again. Number 9. Twilight Sparkle. The only reason, the only fucking reason I dislike Twilight less than I dislike Rarity is because at least it looks like she gives a flying fuck about her friends.
My friends have turned into complete jerks!
Well, most of the time. But she's a nerdy know-it-all. And you know what? I fucking hate know-it-alls. I really do. Ooh, look at me. I'm Twilight. I'm so fucking special. Why I hope a fucking horn blows up in a fucking smug ass face.
I don't get it.
She's always pointing fingers or hooves or why do I fucking care anymore? She is always trying to bring the big solution, and I guess you could see that as a good thing. However, she is supposed to be so freaking smart, but still she is blind for the obvious. She is also an unbelieving Thomas. Remember the pinky sense thing? That's how unbelieving she can be. She is supposed to be so smart, but she can be so blind to the obvious that I just can't believe it. I mean, okay, at some points her friends are just as blind. However, she is supposed to be the smart one, the intelligent ones, and sometimes she just doesn't show it, and that makes her an interesting character for a series like that, but it makes me dislike her character. So that is why she is number 9 on my list. And now number 8, Apple Bloom. But Ardawen, Apple Bloom is so cute. How can you rank her number 8? Well, because that's basically it, isn't it? I mean, sure, she is cute, but I can't believe I said that. But still, you know, that's pretty much it, isn't it? There isn't that much depth into the character Apple Bloom, and I guess that's alright, because she is not really a main character. But that does place her rather low on the list. But I do still like her more than I like Rarity and Twilight. That's for sure. Well, don't get me wrong, I don't have anything bad to say about Apple Bloom. In fact, with Apple Bloom, my list of the characters I do not hate actually starts. But I don't have that much positive things to say about Apple Bloom. Apple Bloom is Apple Bloom, and that is fine, but that does make her number 8 on my list. Number 7, Sweetie Belle. With Sweetie Belle, I pretty much got the same problem as I have with Apple Bloom. She just doesn't make an impression on me. And that doesn't make her a bad character, in fact, she is my number 7. But that just doesn't make her a high-ranked character. The only reason that Sweetie Belle is just a little bit higher ranked than Apple Bloom is her amazing singing voice. Just listen to it. I hope that that lullaby didn't make you fall asleep, because we arrived at number 6, Spike. But Ardawen, Spike isn't a pony, silly. No, shut up. I know that. But didn't I tell you this was a list for main characters, not main ponies? So why don't you die and go to hell? Spike is a little bit of a sarcastic asshole. And you know, I love that. I really do. He's the kind of guy I would have been if I was surrounded by nothing else but girls all the time. Oh God, what a sarcastic dick I would have been then. Anyway, he is actually a really nice guy. He loves his friends and he's always there to help them. The only thing is that he is in love with Rarity. But you know, everyone makes mistakes once in a while. So yeah, Spike is pretty awesome. But his love interest does make him lose a few points in my book. Also, he just isn't as awesome as my top 5. Which is where we have arrived now. Number 5. Applejack. Ah, Applejack, the most loyal of friends and the most dependable of ponies. But that is pretty much the only impression that she makes on me. Now I know that there is much more to her. Well, however, I've made this list without thinking too much of it, and placing Applejack on the 5th place pretty much came natural to me. She is an awesome character. But the other characters just impress me more than she does. Still, number 5 is a really good spot. So let's not talk about it any longer and let's carry on with number 4. Scootaloo. But Ardawen, are you really putting Scootaloo, one of the cutie mark crusaders, on number 4 above Applejack? Yes, yes I did. Like I said, I made this list without thinking too much about it, and I just put Scootaloo on number 4 above Applejack without thinking about it. But when I did thought about it, it actually did make sense. She is actually an awesome little filly and the only one of the 3 cutie mark crusaders who has some character depth in my opinion, or at least the most character depth. Even though we know nothing about her family, her sheer awesomeness is more than enough to place her on number 4. Just let me show you the awesomeness of Scootaloo. She is no Rainbow Dash, but she is damn alright in my opinion. By the way, I also loved it that she pretty much had her own episode. That was a really good move of the writing cast. So even though I don't know exactly why, I'm still putting her on number 4. But she isn't my top 3, which we will see now. So guys, are you ready? Because it is time for my top 3 of my favorite character of My Little Pony, Friendship is Magic. And my number 3 is... Fluttershy! We all know why Fluttershy is my number 3. She is the most kindest, sweetest and innocent soul there is. Unless you make her mad, of course. She wouldn't hurt a fly. Well, okay. First, that wasn't a fly. And second, she wasn't really hurting him. No, Fluttershy is the most kindest, most innocent and sweetest pony in the whole universe, and you cannot deny that. And that is also my only complaint about Fluttershy. I mean, even Discord, the fucking spirit of chaos and disorder, was fucking annoyed by her sweetness and innocence.
Well, it must be so upsetting to know how weak and helpless they think you are.
Not at all. I'm weak and helpless, and I appreciate their understanding.
Yes, well,
sure, it burns you up. I mean,
that they're always pointing out your flaws, right?
Not really. In fact, I think I'm awfully lucky to have friends who want me to be the best I can be.
Oh, for goodness sake!
He freaked out about it. But despite her shyness and irrational fears, she always comes true for her friends. And you would not want to fuck with her. And that is why Fluttershy is still badass in my book. And that is why she is number 3 on my list. Now we are at number 2. Rainbow Dash. Now, I know that placing Rainbow Dash on the top of my list is pretty obvious. But do I really have to tell you guys why Rainbow Dash is ranked so high? I mean, she is fast, she is cunning, she is loyal. Do you know how Discord corrupted her? She made Rainbow Dash believe that Cloudsdale was in danger. All five other ponies were needed to catch her, and when she was finally caught, the first thing she said when she was cured from Discord's spell was this.
What happened? House Ponyville, where are the elements? Did we stop Discord?
And with the very first time she did her Sonic Rain Boom, she was indirectly responsible for the cutie marks of her five friends and the birth of Spike. So yes, Rainbow Dash is cool, daring, fast and awesome, but she is not my number one. No people, my number one is Pinkie Pie. Oh god. Now, I don't think that I would get away with not placing Pinkie Pie on my number one. Seriously, she would probably kill me. Pinkie Pie is the manifestation of the series, in my opinion. She is literally sugar-coated awesomeness. There is no moment with Pinkie Pie in it that doesn't make me smile. And if there is an episode without Pinkie Pie, I always think, needs more Pinkie Pie. I mean, look at her. Doesn't she just make you smell?
No, I'm the real pig. I'm the real pig. No, I'm the real pig. I'm the real pig.
Someone should. Thank you, Trixie. Thank you. Okay. So she is a little bit strange, but that is why we all love Pinkie Pie, am I right? Yes, sir, I love me some strange. Okay, sorry, Pinkie, sorry. Seriously, though, Pinkie Pie kind of reminds me of myself. She is a really, really overactive, sort of, goddess version of me. She's kind and all she wants is make everybody happy, even if they don't want to be happy. She often makes no sense. Hello! And she loves to party! Her insecurity comes from her fears that her friends doesn't like her as much as she thinks she does. And that's just so sweet. Sounds like me, right? But we all do love Pinkie Pie, don't we? Even though we get tired of her sometimes, and her physics breaks even the logic of the world of My Little Pony.
That's not magic, that was just Pinkie Pie.
Oh, by the way, did you know they originally planned to give her wings? Thank God they didn't get through with that, right? I mean, talking about overkill. Pinkie Pie with wings. Oh my god, that would be awful. And one more thing. How can she afford all the money for all her parties? I mean, she is a baking assistant. If you make that much money as a baking assistant, I want to be a baking assistant. Really? But despite all that, Pinkie Pie is still my number one. That concludes my ranking of the My Little Pony Friendship is Magic characters. If you don't agree with me, well, that's fine. Everyone has his own opinion. Let's give each other a hoof bump and let's carry on with our happy little lives, shall we? And that was the very first episode of the show that doesn't have a name yet. I hope you watch it next time, and who knows, the show will have a name. Goodbye!
Doesn't matter now.
What's up?
niet goed genoeg. Echt overnieuw.
Now, before you begin to attack me... Now, before you begin to attack me, I know most male fur... Now, before you begin to attack me, I know most male fans are pretty much just like me.
Hey, you can't talk to Mr. Henke.
I know, motherfucker!
Yeah.
Doot, doot, doot!
Transition!
Oh, lekker. So dildo. Talking about well worked out. Dat is gewoon niks aan de hand pas.
Ik vind het even dat gezicht.
Yeah. Friendship is magic. Horrible! A fucking manticore! Love and tolerate, motherfucker! Love and tolerate!